Right now, I'm on my way to Lindenhurst, Long Island, to surprise Anne-Marie with a reading. Her husband, Chris, set this whole thing up. You know, like, sometimes it's easier to surprise someone, like, at work or something, because they're at least dressed, they have makeup on. Like, if she answers the door like she's not showered or she's in her pajamas, I don't know. There are a lot of things that could go wrong here right now.
I took the time to set this up because I feel like Anne-Marie's always had, like, an empty spot, and I think some closure would really help her.
Open the door. Hello?
Hi.
Anne-Marie!
Yes.
Hi!
Hello, I'm like, I'm not.
Are you in your jammies?
Yes.
Ah, I said it on the way over. I'm like, could you imagine she's in her jammies?
I'm shocked. I can't believe that Theresa just showed up at my door, but I'm so excited because it's been a long time that I've wanted to do something like this, and I'm excited, I'm really excited.
He just told me he knew you were coming. I'm gonna kill him.
That's the whole idea. This is why we surprise people on Long Island Medium.
Oh my God.
This is how it works.
I want to know he's okay and that he can kind of see that we're okay. That's really, I think, the main thing for me.
So you look beautiful.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Need a little shower, a little makeup.
That was quick. Yeah. So, I want to first start with, who passed tragically, but years ago?
My dad.
I go, I would have sworn you were her brother. And he goes, I know, I look good for my age, right?
Oh my God. That's like something he would say.
That would be him, correct?
Yeah. My dad was a very big personality. He was fun. You know, we always had a good time. It didn't have to be some kind of a glamorous vacation for us to have a good time as a family. He just was the best dad anyone could have ever asked for.
He's very handsome, your dad.
Thank you.
He's got really good hair, too.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
He has a full head of hair, though, your dad.
Oh, yeah, full.
And it's like, did he have, like, salt and pepper hair, or like...
Oh, my God, yes. That's... Oh my God, yeah.
Just said to me, he goes, and you know, I could cut the rug, you know, too. Your dad, he's like, you want to learn how to do the Lindy? I'll show you how to do the Lindy.
The Lindy, that's their dance. That's what they would do. The Lindy was my parents' favorite dance. They were very good at it. My dad, you know, would always dance with my mom at weddings doing it, and he would dance with me. He tried to teach me. I'm not very good at it, but, and the it's significant because my mom and I still, to this day, will do the Lindy together.
You have a son?
Well,
you,
I do.
But you having another son?
Yes.
Perfect. So know that your father is validating that he will hold the soul of your son before coming here into the physical world. And knowing that you will see your dad in your son.
And I keep thinking he's going to look like my dad, which is weird.
And that's what he just said. That's what he just said. Okay, what happened when you were 20?
That's when my dad...
Okay, he made me feel this blow to the chest, took a deep breath, and then I just died. He said, Theresa, he said, it made it harder because my death was so quick.
Yeah.
We went from amazing, everyday, happy life to he was gone.
That's pretty much it.
It was a typical day. You know, I was going out with friends in the city. My brother and mom were home. And my father had heard some gunshots from our neighbors. And my father, you know, called the police. Cop car came down our street. So my father went outside to direct the police. It's coming from this house. And when he did that, my neighbor shot him. And he had already killed his mother. So I think he just was killing anyone in his path. I felt so guilty not being there that night.
You feel that you were robbed. You were robbed of your father, and you're angry about that.
Absolutely. He missed out on everything with our lives, our adult lives.
Right. So know that everything that you have said to him, he has heard. And you say, it wouldn't be so hard if I just could have said goodbye. or if I could have hugged him and told him how much I love him.
Just once more.
As I was saying that, did you get the goosebumps? Because your dad told me that he was hugging you at that exact moment. So know that whenever you get the goosebumps or the chills for no reason, know that it is your dad's soul giving you a hug.
I felt something, and I'm like, I can't explain what it was, but I definitely felt something.
Now, did you get married after your dad departed?
Yes.
Because he says, I want you to know that I was at your wedding. I don't know what this is. I don't know if there was an adoption. I don't know if somebody adopted a baby.
My husband was adopted. As an infant.
Wow.
I was so surprised when she mentioned Chris's adoption because that's not something everyone knows about my husband. For him to say that, and he's seen my son and my husband and sees that we're happy, that makes everything better.
So, your father has made it perfectly clear that he knows
everything.
Everything. And then some.
Yeah. And a little more.
Oh my God, that's crazy.
Because he did an amazing job of validating for you.
Good. Thank you so much.
That he has been with you even after 20 years.
I'm going to take from this reading a sense of peace that, you know, I know he's okay and he's happy about, you know, where I am. So I feel like it really gives me closure.
He had an amazing reading.
Thank you.
Oh. Hi, how are you? I'm Teresa.
No, you are.
Nice to meet you. Now, who was the mother figure for you that's departed?
My mother.
Okay.
My name is Bernadette, and I'm from Massapequa, New York. I did see Teresa, and I was watching her as she was speaking, and I was just willing her to look my way and for my mom to step forward and communicate with her.
Was your mom a very excitable person? Like, we get excited? Because she's like, oh, can you just tell her I know how much she misses me? Can you just tell her I know she tells me every day how much she loves me?
My mother died 9 years ago. And she did die from a heart attack. It was sudden. It was unexpected. I miss her every day. Her advice and just being able to speak with her. She always had something good to say.
She goes, and tell her to pick out yellow. Did your mom like yellow?
That's amazing. Yes, absolutely.
What spirit does is they always just do things to let us know that they know what's going on. And that would be your mom, right? If your mom was here, she'd be like, oh, get yellow.
Sure, she would. When Teresa said that my mom preferred the yellow, I definitely felt that it was my mom because my mom would help me make decisions like that. And I think that she knew that I would have been indecisive, but that would have been a color that would have made me happy.
Did your mom also have an issue with her feet?
Yes.
Because she goes, look at my shoes.
Yes.
She goes, tell my daughter I could wear nice shoes again.
That's amazing. Yes, absolutely. She definitely did have a lot of problems with her feet. And
Perfect.
She couldn't wear nice shoes. Everyone who knew her knew that she would often say, I feel wonderful if only my feet didn't hurt. So that was specific. And she did complain to me about her feet about a week before she passed away.
Oh my God, your mom just started crying. And she goes, I'm so happy that I'm able to finally let my daughter know that everything that she senses and feels is really me.
That's so wonderful.
That's amazing.
Thank you so much. I'm so happy I saw you today.
Oh
I
my
really
God,
am.
That's so
I have been looking for signs from my mom for sure. So I feel that this is her way of saying her last words to me that I'm fine, I'm feeling well, and she knows that I'm happy here as well.
Very nice to meet you. Good luck.
Happy
Bye-bye.
Painting, Bernadette.
Have a nice day.